Armbian.
Hello everybody, I am NicoD, I am a moderator at the Armbian forum, and I also review SBCs, so single board computers. In this video I'm going to explain what Armbian is, why we don't do Raspberry Pi, what the build script is from Armbian, what the differences are between Debian and Ubuntu, and also what the difference is between the legacy kernel and the mainline kernel. So these are five things many new people ask on the Armbian website. So first of all, we have to say, what is an ARM SBC? So here is an ARM SBC. An ARM SBC is a computer that runs with an ARM instruction set. So not x86, like from Intel or AMD, but ARM. There are also two differences in ARM. There is ARM HF, which is ARM 32-bit, and ARM 64, which is 64-bit. So this is the NanoPi M4. This is a 64-bit SBC. And for example, here we have got the Android XU4. This was the most powerful 32-bit SBC that I got and that I know about. So these are two things we have to know, ARM HF and ARM 64. But this is for later. So these boards are very cool. You can do a lot with it. But without software, they are nothing, of course. So here comes Armbian. Armbian provides images for as many SBCs as possible if you are able to support them. So, for example, the NanoPi M4 is supported, or even the older Android XU4 is supported. But we don't support Raspberry Pi. This is because Raspberry Pi is actually very different from most other modern SBCs. Raspberry Pi isn't fully open source. They use a very different way to run their software. They have got a hidden main operating system that's called Threadix that runs on the video cores. So that means we are not in control of the Raspberry Pi, but the Raspberry Pi is always in control of itself. Or it should be, because it crashes a lot. This is the worst SBC that I know. So I rather have this one, of course, with Armbian. So next, what is Armbian? Armbian is not an operating system. Armbian provides operating systems for ARM SBCs. So Armbian is actually a build script that builds operating systems, so Linux images, for these boards. So I've already made a video about how to build an Armbian image. Check here above. So with the build script, you can build either a Ubuntu image or a Debian image. And then there are, of course, the versions. So you've got Ubuntu Bionic, you've got Ubuntu Focal. Focal is 2004. So Ubuntu 2004, while Ubuntu Bionic is Ubuntu 18.04. Then Bullseye is Debian 10, I think. I don't use Debian that much, so I'm sorry if I'm wrong. So then what is the difference between Debian and Ubuntu? Well, Debian is optimized for server tasks, while Ubuntu is optimized for desktop tasks. So I use my SBCs a lot as desktops, so I just use Armbian Bionic mostly. Why not Focal? Well, Focal is newer, and newer software also means a lot more problems. That is also another difference between Debian and Ubuntu. Ubuntu uses a little bit newer software that hasn't been completely well tested, while Debian only uses old software that is fully tested. So Debian should be more reliable, certainly for server tasks. So then as last, there is the legacy kernel versus the mainline kernel. What's the difference between that? So for example, when you download an image for the NanoPi M4, you will get the choice of legacy kernel or mainline kernel, and also, for example, Focal or Bionic or Stretch or Bullseye. Those choices you will get, but a very important thing is, of course, the mainline or legacy. This is a bit complicated, but I will try to explain. So the legacy kernel is a kernel that is chosen at one time to support one SOC. So that kernel is maintained so that that SOC will perform great on this kernel. But only this sock will work with that kernel, of course, because that kernel is tailor-made for that sock. So, for example, we have got the legacy kernel for the RK3399s. This one is great, this works very well. There is also the mainline kernel for the RK3399. This also works okay, but there are a few more problems than with the legacy kernel. So it is a choice. Do you want stability or do you want new features? If you want stability, then go for the legacy. If you want newer features, then go for the mainline kernel. The difficult thing is that not always everything will work on legacy or on mainline. So you have to make a choice, you have to compromise. What is more important for me and how can I make it work? So for example, with the RK3399, there is a Panfrost GPU driver for this. This only works with the mainline kernel. But for the legacy kernel, there are VPU drivers. So to have good video playback, that is only in the legacy kernel. So I choose to use the legacy kernel. But I've also have got a second board that I use mainline on. So I have both kernels at the same time. So I guess that's it for today. If you have got more questions, please submit them in the comments here down below. So thank you all for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, NicoD. All enjoy Armbian. Thank you Armbian for being there. I don't work for Armbian. I am just a user. I am a moderator because it's important for me, for my channel, to be aware of everything on Armbian. So don't think that I am paid for this. I just love Armbian, so that is it. So thank you all for watching. Hope to see you all later. Bye!